So in Mistika, when you have a clip in the timeline, if you go to attributes, you will find information of the clip name, the position in the timeline. You could see that over here, we could see that this clip is sitting on timecode 0. And you have information of the out point and the duration of the clip inside the timeline. You also have trim and clip information, which in this case, you could see that it tells you the source time code in the endpoint and the source time code in the out point. And this information, head and tail, is actually how much information has been trimmed from the clip. In this case, we could see that it's 000. What this means is that basically we are seeing the whole clip in this moment. And how do I know that? Well, basically because what I'm going to do here, as we've seen in previous videos, I'm going to move the active frame. And in the active frame, what I'm going to do is choose the option split. And it's going to split it exactly where the active frame was. And you could see here now that this clip has been split in two clips. You could see the source time code and the active frame on the two clips. And now let's click on the second one, and on the second one here, let's see the attributes information. And in the attributes information, we could see that we have the same clip name, of course, but now we have the head information here. Okay, and you could see it's telling exactly the amount of time that we've actually made that cut in that exact clip. And similarly, if I click on the clip and take the active frame to the very end, okay, what we are going to see, I'm going to show the attributes panel here. I'm going to click and drag, and you can see how the tail is coming down, because right now what I'm doing is trimming from the tail of the clip. Okay, something actually quite helpful in the attributes panel is that you could directly modify how much you want of heads and tails here. And for example, if I want to recover the tail that I've just trimmed, I can actually press here 000000, and you can see that it will recover the exact spot. And similarly as well, the other thing that we could do is actually join two clips together. Mistika will see if the time code between the clips. First, it will double check that the clip has the same name, and then if the clip is actually, if the timecode is continuous. So I'll select the clip and press join, and Mistika will join it together. And now I'm gonna zoom out. We could see the clip here, go to attributes, select it, and here obviously now we see the same information that we did before.